Hello, welcome to my YouTube channel. If you don't know me, my name is Delia. Thank you for tuning in. If you have not yet subscribed, please click the subscribe button below. So today I'm trying not to be shy. I am going to try to look straight to the camera, yes? I am going to look into your eyes. I am going to look into your future. Yes, into your future. Today's theme is about future. Yes, because I know there are most people who would really want to better their future. There are many people who have really struggled in their lives. They have tried to do many things in order to reach some goals, but they were not able to reach their goals because of one reason or the other. I know there are many people who would really to go abroad, but they just don't know where to begin, or they have been conned many times and they ended up giving up. And there are just people who thought, why should I end up filling all these forms? Let me just, because they just don't feel like they should fill out the forms. I know there's a lot of process when you want to go abroad. And maybe there are people who just didn't have the money, the finances, and maybe you now have that money and you don't know where to start from. That's why I am there for you today. That's why I am there for you in this channel, in this YouTube channel. That's why I also request you to subscribe. Tell your friends to subscribe. Share with each and everyone. Let's support each other. And together we can grow strong. So, disclaimer. I am not here to promise heaven. I am not here to promise that you are going to... The people are going to get their visas at the German embassy, because that's not my job. I don't work at the German embassy and I even don't have connections. I will be lying if I say, yes, I have connections there. I communicate with this person and the other person. And by the way, you are not even supposed, there's no, I don't know. Let me just stop there. I don't want to say anything wrong. So I am just here. The main purpose, all the purpose of this video, the purpose of this channel is just to encourage people and to help them. I am here to help you know where to start from. I am here to guide you on the whole process, to give you advice what you can do to change things, to give you advice what you can do to get that visa, to give you advice on what you can do when you get the visa and you land in Germany, how you can go on with your life, what you can do. Yes, that's what I've decided to do. So please, if you have ever experienced or you have a bad experience with people or with agencies who have been asking for money, or because you have tried several times to apply for visa, or you have tried several times to go abroad and it just didn't work out, please don't discourage the people who are willing to try it out, because everyone has their dreams, everyone has their own luck, and because maybe you just did not follow up why you did not get the visa. Because when you don't get the visa, you can request the embassy to give you the reasons, and they do that. They'll tell you, okay, maybe you did not present this or that, or you have to fulfill this or that. And if you just sit there and feel helpless or hopeless, then that's not going to be the solution. So let's begin. The first visa type, how you can come to Germany, is through the au pair visa. The au pair visa is a visa whereby you come to Germany and help the German families to take care of their children. You are not supposed to be older than 26 years of age, and you are supposed to show that you have some level of the German language or some knowledge of the German language. By the way, it's very important to have knowledge of the German language if you want to come to this country. Why is this so? It's because German is the national language in Germany, and it will help you to integrate yourself in the society. You don't want to come here and feel helpless because you cannot communicate with other people, because you cannot go on with your own business, because you cannot come You just don't know how to deal with the system. There are lots what you need to do here in Germany. It doesn't mean if you land here that you need to relax. No, by the way, when you land here, that's where the real life begins. You need to be very hardworking. You need to have goals in life. You need to set your goals straight. Are we together here? Yes, that's how or why you can succeed in Germany. Only if you know what you want, and only if you are hardworking and you are not there to give up. So, when you come as an au pair, or before you come as an au pair, you need to have the German language, the knowledge of the German language, and mostly A1 level is required, which is the lowest level. You start with A1. There are very different levels which go from A1, A2, B1, B2, C1, and C2. But I would advise you to learn the German language to at least level A1, because on that level you are able to understand more things. Of course, you learn the language when you learn in Germany. You will learn the language further. But you also want to begin somewhere when you are here. You just don't want to feel helpless. And this, you also have to have a certificate. This certificate should be from the Goethe Institute in Nairobi or from any Goethe Institute in Kenya. Just don't go to any language school and do there some exams and you think, okay, it's now done. No, it should be from Goethe Institute, because that's the only certificate that is recognized. Or you can also learn language in any school. Like for me, for example, I obtained my German knowledge at school. In my high school, we were taught German, and I was able to come to Germany with that level, yes, because I could prove with my KCSE certificate. Okay, when you come as an au pair to Germany, your main work is to take care of the children, but that does not mean that that's the only work you do. You can also help the family with some small house chores. Let's say, for example, help them by cooking, or help them when they are doing some small cleaning job, just some small part. Just be part of the family. That's the aim of the au pair program, to exchange. It's an exchange program whereby you come to Germany to learn how the German culture, to learn how the Germans live, to be part of their family. And you can learn this more when you also take part in their lives. Like when they go to outside or extra to do some activities, try to be part of it. Because only that way you can learn more. And don't shy off to ask them questions if you don't understand anything, because I swear, when I came to Germany, my German was not that good. So there are some things I thought I'd understood. I was assigned some work and I said, yes, yes, I have understood everything. Mm-hmm. I'm going to do it, no problem. And when they came, they asked me, we asked you to do this, why haven't you done it? And I was surprised. So they would end up explaining to me what they meant, and sometimes they got mad because they said, if you don't understand anything, you better ask. We don't want to leave you here knowing that work is done, and when we come back, it's not done. That's extra work for them too. So I can understand that. Excuse me, because I don't know where I have just put my glasses. So I have just noted these things down because it's really a lot of work. I swear that has really costed me a lot of time here. So to those people who have been inboxing me in Facebook, requesting me to answer their questions, I'm very sorry. I was busy preparing this for you, and I could not just answer each and every person. It's really a lot of work. I'm sorry, because I type and type and type. And through this video, I can reach many people at a time. And at the end of this video, if you still have questions, just get in touch with me. Another way of coming to Germany is through a volunteering program. There are two types of volunteering programs. You come as a social year, it's known as FSJ, that is FSJ, Freiwilliges Soziales Jahr, and that is limited to people until the age of 26 years. And there's another social program known as Bundesfreiwilligendienst, BFD, in English, BFD. It's also a social program whereby you volunteer in Germany, and the age limit is 99 years. That means there's no age limit. Anyone willing to come as a volunteer in Germany can come through these programs. There are also other many social programs. Freiwilliges Ökologisches Jahr, FÖJ, whereby you work, I think, with the nature, such things. But I'm just going to focus on these two because that's what how most people also come to Germany. And when you come through these social programs or volunteering programs, you can work in many fields. Most of the fields where people work are nursing homes, yes, or also in kindergarten, in childcare. But let me know, yes, they also work in childcare, and you get some amount of money, that's a pocket money, it's not a lot of it, but it will sustain you, I mean survival for the fittest. Because I know you're watching this video because maybe you've been hustling for long and you're just sitting there and you don't know where to start, and you're just like, oh God, if I just get any opportunity, just any opportunity, I'm going to give my all. And that's it. Give your all. Even if the money might be little, just don't give up, because you must start somewhere. If you want to reach a higher height, you must start the bottom to reach up. So, most of the... Oh God, it's really blending me. So, you can get your... When you do Bundesfreiwilligendienst, you can get your pocket money, like 414 euros. 414 euros is like 41,400 Kenyan shillings. And if you do the Freiwilliges Soziales Jahr, free social year, you will get like 380 euros per month. That's like 38,000 Kenyan shillings. There are some institutions that offer a place where you can stay, and they are free of charge. And there are some places where you must look for yourself where you can stay, and you must pay for that place. So it's up to you to decide and to look which institution is the best for you. I am also there for you if you need information on that. And this pocket money varies from one institution to the other. There are very many institutions. I'm not going to mention any here because I'm not here to market anything. So, yes, you just have to identify which institution best suits you and apply with them. Most social year services or most volunteering programs begin in September, but it also varies from one institution to the other. Okay, that was the reason. Okay, but before I forget, I'm just going to focus on the type of visas, that the long-term visas, because I don't know why I should tell you about the short-term visas, because if you come here, for example, for a visit, or you come here as a tourist, I bet you have enough money, you have a good life, so you are not willing to stay here for a long time. I am going to focus more on these long-term visas, just that you can come and have the possibility to prolong your stay here in Germany, because there are two types of visas. One of it is a national stay visa, and the national stay visa, which is the type D, is the one whereby you can come here and afterwards you can prolong it. And this is why I'm going to focus on this point, which I'm going to explain to you. And there's a Schengen visa, which is a short stay visa that is only valid for 90 days. And after 90 days, you have to go back. By the way, even if you apply for the national visa, you mostly get a visa valid for 90 days. And when you come here, make sure to go to the Alliance Authority to prolong your visa so that you do not find yourself staying here black. I mean, staying black means you are staying without a valid visa, and that is punishable by law. You can end up being deported or paying huge fines. So, that's why I'm... If you want me to also to talk about the short-term visas, please comment in my in the comment section. I'm just going to try to keep this video as short as possible because I know most of you also are using bundles. So excuse me if I'm not going to focus on these short-term visas. And like I said, if you want to know more about it, comment in the section below or also inbox me on Facebook. On Facebook, my name is Daily Ray Dingins. Yes. Okay, another way to come here is through language visa. There's something important you have to note. When applying for the language visa, the language course must be an intensive language course. An intensive language course must have at least 18 hours per week. 18 hours per week. It's not supposed to be less than that. And not that, this is a tip I have for you. You can apply for an intensive language course and you get one at school. When you go to the embassy, you are given a visa for 3 months. Okay, maybe you apply at school a language course for 1 month or for 2 months, for 3 months. And when you go to the embassy, yes, you get the visa according to that type, a short-term visa. So make sure when applying for the intensive language course, please make sure that you apply for one that goes for at least 4 months. Not less than that, at least 4 months. You can take even the one that goes for 5 months or 6 months. That depends on your pocket if you have enough money, because it's also not cheap. It costs a lot of money. It costs a lot of money. So, why? Why is it that when you apply for the language course, that it should go for at least 4 months? Because when you apply for your visa, you have the chance to get, you'll be applying for a national visa. Are you getting me? The national visa will allow you to have a longer stay in Germany. That means when you come to Germany, even if you have got a visa valid for 90 days, that's 3 months, when you arrive in Germany, you will go to the Alliance Authority and prolong it. Of course, they prolong it according to the period of time your language course is going to last. But something else, what is very important, and this is really a tip for you, you have the possibility to do something else. You have the possibility to change your visa to something else. That's only after the language course has ended. That's by the end of the language course. So after, let us say, 4 months, I think and I bet you have prepared yourself what you're going to do next after your language course ends. You can apply for a residence permit, which maybe you are granted for 1 year, and after 1 year you have to prolong it. And yeah, that's it. And you can also extend the language visa for at least 1 year. But please note, if you are planning to do your language course for 1 year and you're planning to do the language course for 1 year, you are not allowed to extend your stay after that. You cannot change the visa to something else after that. You must go back home after that 1 year. Even if you want to study then after the language course, you must go back home and apply for a study visa. So you go back, apply for a study visa, and hope that you get it. I bet you'll get it. I hope you'll get it. I don't know. I cannot influence that. I am not a magician. I wish I was. I would help the whole world. I would help anyone and everyone, anything and everything. But I'm not. advise you to better do a shorter language course, not only because of the finances, but because of that reason that you do not, or you must not go back home after your language course ends. You must have prepared yourself what you want to do next after the language course ends. When you have a language visa, you cannot apply for a work permit. That means you are not allowed to work. So, you must have enough finances when you come here, or you must have someone who is going to support you. There are people who come here or have relatives or good friends who are willing to support you. Yeah, you know, you also have to prove to the embassy that you are able to sustain yourself when you're here. So, take note of that. Yes, I talked about it, that going back home, and this is something, oh God, this is something that most of you have really, really, really requested me. Please, can you please look for a work for me? Can I come and work? Can I come and work straight? Darling, yes, keep listening, keep watching, keep tuned in, and if you have not yet subscribed, please subscribe and the subscribe button below. Share it with your friends, like and comment. You can come to Germany and work. Yes, you can come here and work and earn some money, man. You can come here and work. And let me begin. In Germany, there are two types of work. There is regulated work and there's non-regulated work. Most of the German professions are non-regulated. What's the difference between these two kinds of professions? The first profession, the regulated ones, you need to have an official recognition of your qualifications. That means you have to apply to the authority, to the German authority. They should approve. They should approve your qualifications, that they are similar to the German system. Are you getting me? That means, and there are professions which, there are specific professions which fall under this category. I'm just going to mention a few. The professions which fall under the regulated professions are in the health service, like a nurse, or in legal advice, like a lawyer, or in teaching, or a teaching profession, or engineering. So, make sure if you are already a nurse or an engineer or the things I've mentioned, get in touch with the right authority, the German authority, present your paper, send them your qualifications, and they'll go through them. They'll tell you if your qualifications are enough or if you need to do something about it. Or there's also a database known as ANABIN, A-N-A-B-I-N. You can go and search about it and give and type your profession, then you just find out if it is qualified or not. The non-regulated profession, what most professions in Germany are the ones that may require an official recognition, but they must not be officially recognized. They must not. Not the first one, you must, in the first one that I've mentioned, that must, you must recognize your qualification. And by the non-regulated ones, you must not recognize them. It differs from one profession to the other. There's no specific law or regulation as to which process this concerns. So I'd advise you, in any way, just get your qualifications recognized. Or if you don't know, just check the ANABIN link and you'll get guided there. And non-regulated professions are, for example, if you have a degree or you have completed a vocational training, and e.g. as computer scientist or a baker, you can come to Germany and work as a computer scientist or a baker. These two examples that I've mentioned are really things you can just, you must not have to present your papers to be analyzed if they're equal to the German system. If you are over 45 years of age and want to come to Germany, there's a regulation on that. You are, and you want to come to Germany, let us say you have already gotten a job in Germany and you are already 45 years or above, your annual salary, your annual gross salary must be 46,000, at least 46,860 euros. Yes, that's almost 47,000 Kenyan shillings per year, which you should be earning when you come here. Or if your annual gross salary is less than that, you must have adequate support, or you must show the authorities that you have enough money, or you have something that you have saved up for your pension, because they don't want you to end up poor when you get old, at all age. Let us say the pension age at the moment is 67 years. So imagine you are 45, you come to Germany, and in 22 years, you will not have saved enough in your pension scheme, so you will not get enough money later. So it's better if you already have some plans regarding that. So, there's also another visa. So, I had told you guys, when you want to come to Germany, it's better you send your papers to get approved if they equal the German system or not. And in some cases, the papers don't get approved. That means you have to begin somewhere. And in some cases, maybe you don't have a degree, you have not completed any vocational college, you have just completed Form 4 and you want to come here. What you can do, it's also possible to come in Germany as a training, on a training and skill development visa. On a training and skill development visa, you will get a residence permit later. Okay, you, like I said, you get a first.